time. We have a very special guest here tonight. And I've known him quite a long time. As a matter of fact, I met him when he was just starting to do the Conan O'Brien show. And he was just telling me incredible stories in the dressing room about how that came about and his history with Bruce and the whole amazing story. But he has his own big band, he has another band, he's just got bands everywhere. And he's a lovely man and a big fan of Buddy's. And he's a great guy, and I think you're going to enjoy him. His name is Mr. Max Weinberg.
Greg, how about this fantastic band? The drums of Greg Potter, ladies and gentlemen. Channeling you know who. Kathy, that was delightful to hear you sing once again. Everyone, I'm glad to be here. Kathy said, I'd like to tell you a couple of Buddy stories that I had throughout my history with Mr. Buddy Rich. So my drum teacher, way back in the 50s, in suburban New Jersey, was about 10 years younger than Buddy Rich, and Buddy Rich was his hero. He wanted to be Buddy Rich. That was his era. His name was Gene Thaler. Taught me how to play the drums. I was a little kid. And in his basement, he had pictures of Buddy Rich. And he was sort of a hip cat, Gene was. Great drummer, but everything had to swing, and I was sort of a rock era guy. In any case, so I knew the name Buddy Rich before I actually ever heard Buddy Rich play. Became a big fan, obviously, like everybody here, later on. The first time I met Buddy Rich was at the Bottom Line, if you remember that. It was over on, I think, West 4th, one of those streets by NYU. And he played every April, just about this time. He played every April, every year, and the owners there, Bruce and the E Street Band, had quite a, what turned out to be something of an infamous gig for us in 1975. So I knew the owner. He'd always save the front two tables where it was a little elevated because, you know, you had a room full of drummers and their girlfriends or their wives. And the women loved Buddy Rich. And the guys, the drummers generally, just went bananas over Buddy Rich. So I was in the dressing room this one night that I met him, the first night I met him. I was in the dressing room, and I've told this story before, but it was just so... I didn't know him at all. It was just so typical. Buddy Rich, to me, was fabulous. There were three or four other drummers there, and, you know, we're all, like, you know, going crazy over Buddy Rich, and there were some guys asking him questions about drummers. I was just kind of sitting there, and he was Mr. Rich to me. And we got on the subject. He got on the subject of footwear. And he was very concerned about what the young rock drummers were wearing on their feet when they played the drums. Really, he was very, very serious about it. He took it very seriously because he said, well, part of my thing is I have these heels. I wear boots when I play and it has these heels and I keep my heel down and I'm able to get all that leverage. And he was explaining why it was important to wear shoes with leverage. And we're taking it all in. And suddenly there were three or four of us in there. He goes around the room and he looks at one guy. Well, what do you when you play the drums? What do you put on your feet? And the guy says to him, kind of a semi-well-known drummer. He says, "Well, I actually wear loafers." And then Buddy says, "What are you, a college kid? Penny loafers?" Goes to the next guy. Well, what do you wear? I wear cowboy boots when I play jazz. You can imagine his reaction. He said, "I hate country music." That goes to the third guy. I'm last. I'm the last guy. You know, he doesn't know me from Adam. I think he knew one or two of the other guys. He says, "All right, well, what are you wearing your feet?" He goes, "Hey, well, Buddy, I play barefoot. Cover the children's ears." And Buddy looks at me with disdain and says, "Fuck you." Excuse me. He gets to me right after this guy. And he says, "So, kid, what are you wearing your feet?" I said, "Mr. Rich, I wear sneakers, but they look like a boot." And he laughed. Right? I got a laugh out of Buddy Rich. And again, I've never forgotten that. That was back in around 77 or 78. And it was just a wonderful memory, because if you're a drummer in the audience, and it's so wonderful to see Greg playing this music, and so fabulous to have Kathy and Greg keeping this music alive. Having taken a big, yes, that deserves a round of applause. Having taken a big band on the road myself for about 8 months, this, you know, other ways to lose money. But now I got a trio. But this music is very well and alive with these musicians, Greg on drums and Kathy singing. So we really thank them for that. If there's drummers out in the audience, you know, when they talk about the greatest, there's Muhammad Ali, there's Michael Jordan, Mario Lemieux from the Pittsburgh Penguins. Buddy Rich was the greatest drummer, I believe, in history. This is my firm belief. And he was the history of the music. History of 20th century jazz, and he was a delightful guy. He actually gave me his phone number once, and I used to call him from time to time just to get Buddy Rich on the phone, you know? I had nothing to say, but I never asked him about drumming. Always talked about, he was such an erudite guy, and he would talk about anything, and I know I'm taking a little time away from the music, but, you know, I'm definitely a bit of a prophet of Buddy Rich, because I love talking about him, I love the man, I miss him dearly, I miss him every day. He gets me going, whether it's Bugle Call Rag or Channel One Suite or West Side Story or even the ballads. The ballads are fantastic. Gets me going. In any case, he was the greatest. And when you're called the greatest, that's a lot to live up to. And drummers everywhere, I believe, if they're honest, we all want to be Buddy Rich. But there was only one Buddy Rich. There will never be another Buddy Rich. But all of us, whenever we sit down to the drums, we carry a part of his beat. And while we'll never be Buddy Rich, we're never going to give up trying to be Buddy Rich. So I'm going to do my, you know, as they say, I'm really not a jazz drummer. I just played one on TV. Like a doctor, you know? I'm really a rock drummer. I'm going to give it a shot because these guys are so cooperative and, you know. And it's Kathy and Greg's band, so they gotta do, they got to play with me. All right, so I'm going to play a song, a couple songs.
One, two.